Hello there, Matt with LINBIT here. In the following video, I'm going to show you how you can replicate data across any distance without impacting the performance of your applications by using DRBD Proxy. By default, DRBD replicates block devices synchronously, meaning we don't consider a write complete until it's been written to all of its peers. This is known as Protocol C. This mode should not be used to replicate over large distances, since your replication network's latency becomes your disk's write latency. With Protocol A, DRBD's asynchronous mode, we consider the write complete as soon as it's placed into the local kernel's TCP send buffer. This means we don't have to wait for a replicated write and subsequent ACK to complete the round trip to the peer before our application can continue writing data. Obviously, this is the mode we'd choose for replicating over a WAN. However, if the kernel's TCP send buffer fills up, DRBD will still need to wait for some of that buffered data to flush onto the wire before it can place any more replicated writes into the buffer, and therefore cause IO wait for our applications. That's the problem DRBD Proxy was developed to solve, and that's what I'll show you in this video. First, I'll show you what happens when a large volume of writes come in from an application without DRBD Proxy in the stack, and I'll repeat the test with DRBD Proxy in the stack so we can see the difference in our performance. On screen right now, you'll see I have terminals open to the local node here at our US office in Beaverton, Oregon, and the DR node in a data center in Portland, Oregon, which is about 16 miles from here. So these nodes are replicating a DRBD device, DRBD 0, which is currently mounted on slash data. The network latency between these two nodes is jumping around, looks like 17 to 25 milliseconds. Our average reported here is actually closer to 19, so we'll go with that, 19 milliseconds. And the bandwidth is capped out around 25 megabits per second, or about 3 megabytes per second. So let's create a file on our DRBD device and see how quickly we can write it out without proxy in the stack. And I'll just use DD to create a 40 megabyte file in our mount point. Okay. The file was written out at 2.9 megabytes per second, which is about the throughput of our network. Which is what we would expect when not using DRBD Proxy. So let's add DRBD Proxy to the configurations, and I've wrote a little script to adjust these for us quickly. And we'll run our same test again and see how quickly we can write that file out with DRBD Proxy in the picture. Just make sure we're connected. We're still connecting. Okay, and we're connected. So here's that same write again with proxy in the stack. That completed almost instantly. We can see we got 269 megabytes per second. And that's what I expect from the underlying storage on these testbed nodes. And that's what you should expect. You should expect to see the performance of your underlying storage when using proxy. So let's go ahead and we'll run the same test with a slightly larger file, and I'll show you what's actually happening behind the scenes. Okay, so we're now looking at DRBD Proxy's write buffer flushing to our peer in Portland. It's flushing as fast as the network can handle, which is still 3 megabytes per second, but instead of our write performance being bottlenecked by the limited space available to the kernel's TCP send buffer, our performance impact is still almost zero because we're able to buffer our entire write in DRBD Proxy's buffer. That size is defined by the user in the DRBD configuration. DRBD Proxy also has the ability to compress writes in its buffers before sending them across the WAN. Many compression algorithms are supported. zlib, LZMA, LZ4 being the most popular. But these can make replication over unimpressive WAN links possible, and that's where we see those being used. So this demo showed systems running DRBD Proxy directly on the DRBD nodes, but DRBD Proxy can be installed on separate dedicated proxy boxes as well. You can also mix replication modes using synchronous replication for high availability clustering between some peers at your primary site, and then asynchronous replication for offsite disaster recovery purposes to other peers. Both HA and DR failovers can be manual or automated by other components of the Linux cluster stack, all of which are packaged and supported by LINBIT. So if you're interested in learning more about DRBD Proxy or anything else you've heard about in this video, head on over to linbit.com and reach out. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.